All right, good evening. Time for Athens. Yeah, I definitely have a plan for this one. Well, this is Athens. You are a one province minor vassal of Blurple, which is already quite disgusting. And the aim of this run is to recreate the borders of Alexander the Great. I've got a map of that printed out somewhere, but not to hand. I don't think I'll be in any need of referencing it in this first session, but hey, what can we do? So, we are Athens, we are Lombard culture, our only province is Greek, we are Catholic, our only province is Orthodox. We pay quite a chunk of our money to the Blurple Beast, which is disgusting, and we need to right this wrong straight away. Now, I would love to just only live once style declare on him straight away, but he would probably kick my ass. It's been known to happen. So let's prepare ourselves for that eventuality. But money is tight, so let's keep the budget tight. Let's not pay anyone anything. And look for any friends. Now, Poland and Austria, probably going to want them in due time, but we'll consider that later on. Byzantium really don't like Genoa, so while the going is good, we are definitely having them on our side. I don't think that would be quite enough to take them, but who knows. It would be lovely if the Ottomans would support our independence, but no. They hate our guts, they want us dead, and they will likely succeed with that. I get the feeling this is going to end up being annexed by Ottoman Simulator 2015, but let's hope that it is not. Now, I don't know if anybody else would support my independence. It would be lovely if... Oh, okay, that's a game changer and a half. Venice would. Okay, right. Why, yes. That would be nice. So, let's hope we get that on the go. Wow, this could be easier than I thought. Welcome, welcome, Byzantium. You may not have an alliance. Pretty glorious. Whilst we're at it, let's get those improvements up with Poland as well. And there is no achievement to be gained from this run, that's correct. Get an extra troop on the go, because why not? None of these things are likely to happen. Oh, that is actually more than likely to happen at some point. But we'll hold off on that one. Skandenburg is putting his brass bollocks to the test and failing miserably. I feel sorry for you, son. And a bit more. Now we'll get that papal influence. That is incredibly nice. We get backing from Venice as well. They're not even a rival of Byzantium. They just love us. Cool. Alright, well, let's hope that stays that way. And in the meantime, let's get some mutual loving going on with Austria. Jake, how does it feel to be playing a pre-Common Sense EU4 after living it up as Venice? Common Sense is pretty good, especially with development. So it's going to be quite frustrating when I can't just click buttons to make my provinces considerably better. You know, I'm sure everyone has dreamed of having Osel as the best province in the world. Or is that just me? Whatever the case, can't make it happen right now unless I get stupidly lucky with events. But in Common Sense, I can do all that and more. Jake, can you not culture shift to Persian and form Persia? That achievement pretty much requires everything as Alex's former empire. No, I want to stay as Athens. You know, I love grey as a colour, so might as well plaster my favourite region in grey. Gobbling up all of my favourite culture. Just gotta make it happen. Alright, I have already made a terrible mistake. We want to be collecting from trade here, and collecting from trade here. I'm not sure if that's the best, but I'm putting my neck out saying it's going to be more lucrative. Oh, 0.03 ducats extra a month. Loads of money. Alright. So far, so not bad. Let's just chill out for a bit and enjoy my very noisy fan these days. Not forming Greece, Jake. I am Lombard culture, so no. Best I could do is form Italy. Little disgusted by this, you are able to convert land at a frightening pace. Utterly disgusting. Now, about you, Ottomans. You have the mission Vassalize Wallachia. Not even taking the mission to get the City of World's Desire. Don't even know what to make of that. Actually, what should I make of that? No, sir, I do not like it. Well, let's try and save up a bit of dosh. And I'm curious to see how great our king would be, but if we fall into a regency, then we cannot declare war, and that would be terrible. Also, kind of want these guys to be more on my side. Staying Catholic Lombard then, Jake? I'm not sure about the Catholic, but I will be staying Lombard. Of course, I need to convert it to Lombard before I can... I need to convert it to Catholic before I can change the culture. So, as with most of my games, a terrifyingly exciting start. I know. Where do I get the energy? Both my supporters are at peace. This can only be good. Just kinda want to kill Blurple straight away. He did snag an alliance with Serbia, sadly. And he's boasting 6,000 men. I only have 4. And to bring myself up to 6 would cost me everything I own. And there's no guarantee I'd win one bad roll. And it all goes peep-tong. Still, what can we do but sit back and enjoy the faster speed? Doesn't seem like you're going for a claim on Constantinople. It's actually really disappointing that you chose the Vassalized Wallachia mission. I had an idea, but I guess it's out the window if you go with that. Is it possible to full annex Blurple in your independence war? That's what I would like to do. You know, I wonder how keen Austria is to back me. Not keen at all, mostly due to being neutral. Harumph. Two out of 10, not Sikh yet. Ah, good to know the people that are watching this. Okay, I'm going to give Ottoman a chance. I'm just gonna go in speed 5 because it is cruise control for awesome and see what happens. Because I'm curious what goes on after Skanderborg falls. He gets some pretty beefy fort defense. Alright, he's gone, which means let's start paying our troops for a change. And you know what, even our boats, let's lose some money. Because who needs that stuff? So, tell me, my man, what are you going to do? You're lining up your troops by Byzantium. But for all I know, you're also lining up next to Wallachia. So let's mark Wallachia as someone of interest. I'm going to Biga. What could it be? Come on, my broham Venice, let's make another fourth crusade. is going awfully far that direction. If he keeps going that way, I wouldn't be surprised if his plan is to do his reconquest now. Hard to tell. Good to keep an eye on the AI. Oh, speaking of which, I can't be having my diplomats away at this crucial point in time. That would be horrible. Jake, how do I send you save files? Stick them on Mediafire and send me a link. Use the uploads on the plaza. You have many choices. Also, please don't put notice me Jake Senpai at the end of your bug reports on the plaza. Makes me throw up a little. Alright, so this is not the greatest start known to man. I do not like it when I rely on the AI to make moves before I make my own. Is this a Theodoro-style one-shot? Let's all hope not. Can you get Georgia to help? I never even considered that, but no, they're friendly towards Blurple. Let's hope they don't ally. That would be a kick in the teeth. Don't think you're going to want to help us out, given how preoccupied you're becoming. Alright, so we have the most placid Ottomans we've seen in a while. He's obviously so satisfied with owning Skanderbeg's lands that he's calling it a day here. It's not particularly great news for me. Yeah, the knight's not so keen to help, Cyprus not so keen to help. Come on, Ottomans, you've got that claim. Put it to use. Lazy git. Thankfully, our two supporters are still at peace, but for how long? Kandar doesn't want to help out either. Alright, so if I was playing as any other nation, I'd be super happy at how laid back the Ottomans are right now. It's kind of funny how if they weren't hostile towards me, the Ottomans would back my independence. And Naples is still under Aragon, so they wouldn't help us out. Alright. Hungary is going for Wallachia. With a bit of luck, they might just annex them super fast. And then the Ottomans start taking City of World's Desire instead. Oh well. Let's chill out for a bit. Oh, he's moving north. That is a surefire that he's either going to gun down Wallachia or Byzantium. Usually puts his troops on the border of where he's going for, and the fact that he's going up this way spells bad news for Blurple. Although if he keeps going north, then it's bad news for me. Alright, so Blurple is probably about to die. And since I'm his vassal and allied to him, probably means I'm going down as well, so glad we're paying our troops here. And I hope my ships are platinum docked. Come on, Ottomans. Spit on your face. How you like that? Jake, that's a position for declaration of war on Blurple. Come on, Ottomans. Do it. I'm waiting for you. You're going to see the greatest repelling of Ottoman forces you have ever seen. Alright, Ottomans declared war on Byzantium. They took their time, I mean that was almost 3 years, crazy. But I have a little trick up my sleeve that's going to murder these guys. Alright, so they're moving in on us. Not moving in on me, thankfully. So, 19th, huh? Interesting. And you're running away. Okay. Well, what I'm going to do is put all of my faith in... What's this guy's face? Nereo II Acciaioli. Alright, sure, whatever. Well, he's pathetic. But whatever, just the kind of guy we need to lead our armies. But to be honest, I am too big for my boots. Serbia won't help you. They won't help you. Huh? That's probably a bug. Won't help because we're in a war together. That's pretty sweet. Pretty damn sweet. In any case, I don't think we have anything else to do, so let's come through fight. So, our good friends Genoa and Venice are helping us out, and straight away we are engaged in hand-to-hand combat with the Byzantines. We didn't exile. Why? Because we were in a war together, so it counted as valid land up until that last moment, or at least that's what I'm blooming well hoping. So, yeah, we take a few losses here, but the Ottomans come and back us up. Oh boy, do they back us up. As usual, we do our movement so that we can stop ourselves without taking any attrition. Wiped out the forces here. And who was first at this siege? Oh, I think you'll find it was me, so Ottomans, go home. You're not welcome here. Oh, and whilst we're at it, I would not mind a bit of that prestige if you could hold out. Okay, the Ottomans warn us, but so what? We're at war, but that's no reason that we can't start getting some much beefier allies. Oh, shoot. Genoa is requesting you come to their aid against the Milanese conquest of Liguria. Is it just Milan? Because I don't want to get tied up in something here. Oh, the Pope as well? This could be pretty bad. Actually, no. The Pope joined on our side. Milan's friends include nobody. No, I think we got this. But is there a reason I would want to be at peace? Possibly, but let's just accept it anyway. I mean, we're good guys around here. And great, we joined in this little scuffle. Oh, and I'm not liking this whole no stability thing, so... Oh, not liking that either. Right, we can consider the increasing in stability another day. 190. Ugh, that's horrible. Forget it. Another day. So, we command the Ottoman troops at the gates of Constantinople. Thanks a bunch, my friend. Oh, and we might as well have our boats over there as well, so that we can get a bit of that loot. You should convert to Orthodox. Not beyond that idea. But here's the thing, if I convert to Orthodox, there's a good chance these folks will not want to ally me, due to being a different religion. What I should try to do is seal the royal marriages first. Don't want to get that malice for wrong religion when getting these royal marriages. Okay, so far so not bad. Oh, Serbia did join in. I guess it was, I guess it was a correct tooltip at the time, but this is probably not an expected action. Now, here's something. I would not have been able to declare this war if I had less than 50 liberty desire. That's, something to prevent you from doing that. Basically, the AI can't do it, so you get some restriction. At least I think that's the way I see it. Ottomans are very kind enough to destroy Serbia for us, so we might just be able to separate piece them for a thing or two. Maybe I can convince our good man Venice to go up to Serbia, cap it for us. That would be nice. Jake, don't convert to Orthodox, convert to Ibadi or Sikh. Yeah, you guys don't demand much, do you? Well, at least we don't have to pay our vassal fee anymore. Let's just enjoy this. Also, looking a little preoccupied there, Milan. You remind me of this other Milan player I once destroyed. Don't mind losing spy defense, it is a worthless stat. Dip Rap Advisor would make these things easier. Do I have one available? I'm always kind of frustrated when you're available at the start. Makes me feel like I'm using the biggest crutch known to man. But it would seal one of those royal marriages. I think it's a plus 10 to royal marriage, so it would actually get me both. Might be worth the money, actually. Jake's Zoroastrian playthrough someday. I have so many campaigns I want to do when Common Sense hits. Like you would not believe. Now, what is also good about this lovely little truce I've got with the Ottomans. Sure, it's only until 52, but that does give me a bit of breathing space, especially since he has rivaled me. Not rivaled me, warned me. Come on, Venice. Don't get cold feet. You know as well as I do, I can't annex them until Serbia's out of this war. Or 5 years are up. But I don't think we have anything to worry about, so we can speed for it at the very least, but I do want those royal marriages. I think different religion is a minus 10 to alliance, not to mention we're going to lose 25... 35? 35 if not 45 opinion from that. So that's all not very good. The trouble is I want to boost my stability for considerably cheaper than that. You know what? Let's just increase it anyway. I mean, you get tens of thousands of admin points throughout a campaign. Let's not cry over 90. Oh, thank you. Constantinople is ours. And you know what is particularly great about that, apart from everything? We now control the Bosphorus and this important center of trade, and we're already collecting here. So all of the blurple trade at the turn of the month, because that's how things are calculated. Also making sure that these guys are not at sea for the turn of the month, because then they would take the 1% naval attrition. Lovely jubbly. We're actually making an extra whole ducat a month. Oh, and we got the loot from Constantinople, so it just goes from good to even better. And they're kind enough to help us out with that siege, so we don't even have to spend our attrition stuff. Milan gives the ducats and more ducats, typical Genoese tactics. So, how do we deal with these fellows? We can get the marriage with you, but not with you. Might even be worth the advisor. Halved malices, yeah, I'm aware. Alright, we are almost fully capped up with you, and we could easily get an alliance with you. So, well, that's after this war is over. We're in an aggressive war, so that's a big old minus 1,000. I still want to have everything ready so that we can nail those alliances good and soundly. The Greek patriotism we're getting is a bit unfortunate, but what you gonna do? We can blockade a total of one base tax. Ah, but Venice is helping us out with that. Thank you, Venice. Also, not very keen on getting a regency so early, so let's put you away until Francesco is of age. Lovely. 8 months, wow. Jake, Are you not put off by the Athenian ideas? I've always been put off playing them because their ideas are so starkly mediocre. Well, we never did go through them, so let's slow it down and think them through. So you start off with stability cost and fort defense. Nothing wrong with that. Legitimacy. Ugh. Accepted culture minus 15, which is... Ugh. I don't tend to go the acceptance route. Dip rep is great. Prestige is great. Unrest is good. Missionary strength is good. That is kind of lackluster. And morale plus 10. They're pretty alright. I wouldn't write home and say, Mom, today I played with a nation that had great ideas. But they're pretty good. Let's get those royal marriages rolling. So we are comfortably in the get an alliance with Poland stage. Thankfully, Poland and Austria have not rivaled each other, so we shouldn't have any issues there. And if I want an alliance with Austria, then I'm going to have to get a dip rep advisor. But we're making the good money. We will also make the good money once Blurple becomes our capital. I mean, I will probably want to do that, but that's not what I'm gunning for here. Jake, don't annex Blurple, just let them be occupied. No, I can't really risk all those rebel uprisings so soon. Oh, this is probably going to happen soon, so let's go with that. For the sake of our stability, we really have to convert to Orthodox. There's no guarantee we'll stay Orthodox, because religious ideas are the greatest ideas in the game. We'll probably be picking them up. Oh, that's right, you're still in this war, aren't you? We need to change that. Sadly, we don't command any of these sieges. Oh, we do. Oh, boy, we do. Serbia, you are coughing up the ducats. Tempted to convert at this stage, but I think there's a better way about this. I hope there is. Jake runs away from the new papacy system once again. You caught me there. I just don't like playing Catholics. Is that so wrong? Alright, we've got Serbia's capital. They are on their last legs, so we're taking the money. We are taking all of the... Probably better to take the war reparations. But yes, those ducats will fuel our machine of blood and bone for a while to come. How funny it would be if I'd accidentally made peace with Blurple there. Okay, so how are we going to do this? How indeed? I think this is... Well, we might as well put that money to use. Let's get the dip rep advisor. Always feels like a crutch. Never feel good about that. So we are comfortably-ish in the region of... Oh, the alliance with Venice is hurting us there. I would probably dump Venice for Austria in a heartbeat. Although our dip rep is going to suffer from the overextension, but vis-a-vis. So how do we do this? I can't dissolve your alliance right now because we're at war. Probably should have done that whilst I had the minus 3 stability, then I could have just laughed it off. I want to start converting you so that I can be sure to get not Greek patriots here. Jake, don't feel bad. They are merely tools to be used and thrown away the next day. That's correct. Jake, build up to force limit. We're way ahead of you. If you mean build up to my future force limit, then I cannot see into the future. Breaking the heart of the city of romance. What is the city of romance? Okay, so unfortunately you are still Greek patriots. That is very unfortunate. I really would like to flip to Orthodox. Like, I would really like to flip to Orthodox. I'll give it the turn of the year and pray that that makes a difference. But it might just be because Greek also already has a Now, what do you call it? A progress. But what do I know? Yeah, they're still Greek patriots. We are definitely going to be seeing problems from them. Oh well. We can make peace, dump Venice, and... oh, whatever, let's just roll with it. Come on, full annex. Everybody's gonna hate us for that, but that's fine. There is no other option here. Well, not that I can see, at least. Let's go for it. Welcome to the full... oh. Goodbye, stability. I knew you well. Goodbye, Venice. Never loved you. Austria. Ugh. That's a little horrible. But at least we can get Poland. How can we overcome that little bit? Ah, well, that's something to worry about for the future. How are we on the coring situation? Yeah, I'm going to want Constantinople cored, and it really blows to lose that. Really blows. Let's keep that on the screen for just a little while longer. Ah, oh, good, we've got the Orthodox Zealots. Sadly, I want Austria as a friend. Ah, okay, that works. Alright, this could even work. So we get our double friendship on the go, once we have both of them free. Let's get it. I need to wait a month. Hope that they turn defensive towards me, both of them. National focus? No, I'm keeping it balanced for now. I could end up needing one or t'other. We really enjoy the fact that we have our... great, they are both defensive towards us. Praying that this works. If it doesn't, I am going to be laughably weak. Right, when can we send another guy already? Okay. Let's become Orthodox. That instantly breaks our alliances. And let's get those alliances back. And we dare not hover over the opinion lest it change. And they accept our alliance again. If I had waited, I think a turn of a month, or hovering over the, I'm kind of circling around it without touching it, but their feelings towards us would have gone neutral, and I probably would not have gotten our alliances back. So there we go. We keep the alliances. We are Orthodox. We are slightly more stable. And I feel like I wasted all my time boosting my stability. We are going to get that war exhaustion down, though. Ugh, both of these are horrible, but we won't need missionary strength for a wee while. So there we go. So, here we go. Athens, fairly unstable, likely to revolt. Very likely to revolt. So, straight away, we are increasing the autonomy everywhere. Tempting to core these two, but Constantinople is the maximum priority. And they... It's only an accepted culture, so if somebody forced the Byzantines out of us, we wouldn't really have any recourse to that. Alright. Not too shabby. Poland have Lithuania under them, and their prestige is high. Holy Roman Greyskin is ruled by Austria, but it's not uncontested. And there's nothing saying we couldn't get Muscovy on our side somewhere down the line, but I would not want to antagonize the Pole. Unfortunately, our expansion options are severely limited here, because the Ottomans have warned us, meaning we can't fight anybody that borders the Ottoman. But Venice does not... Venice does border the Ottoman. Who doesn't, though? Naxos. I'm not sure if that would count. As in... would the Ottomans get involved if I declared war on Naxos? It's not impossible. Austria hate Venice, so they would probably get involved. But Venice allied Castile, and Castile would get involved over the seas, so I may have to write off Naxos, but only for now. Which really, really begins to limit me. What if I fight someone that you hate? There's no such person that I'm able to quickly get. Jake, now you have new force limit, gonna need it for those rebs. You got that right, but at least we have income now. Wow. A perfect zero. Don't see that every day. Oh, yeah. We're gonna need to build up to force limit, folks. I'll get right on that. Whoops. Alright, what in the world is next? To be honest, didn't expect it to go so smoothly so far. We were able to drop the Genoa as an ally without having to break the alliance ourselves. It's just because we flipped religion. So we do have two nice beefy allies, but... is all I can really say about that. I need to consider paths for expansion now. Stability is low, there's nothing really stopping us going the no CB route, but we did clock quite a bit of aggressive expansion for our actions against Blurple. I don't know why, annexing Byzantium really should reduce your global aggressive expansion by 1,000, but I got shot down at that when I brought it up as an improvement suggestion. Some people have no taste. Well, at the very least, it couldn't hurt to have that claim on Naxos. And that claim on Crete, as we consider things to do later on. Jake, trade conflict. Now you're talking. Who has the trade in Constantinople? Well, that kind of rules that one out fairly swiftly. Mind you, we are really going to need to stabilize our nation, so a bit of peace wouldn't go amiss. 40% Morean nationalists? Sure. Sure. Don't like doing it, but this is one situation where I will likely end up having to use harsh treatment. It's not my own military technology that I'm going to be relying on anyway, so we can let it slump a little bit. Oh, I can finally have rivals. Oh, no, I can't. I'm pathetic. Jake, you can no CB the Teutons to get the Livonian t-shirt. Since you're allied with Poland too. But here's the thing, we are going to recreate the borders of Alexander the Great at his height. Somebody sent me their interpretation of that as a map. I will probably stick it somewhere visible when I find a bit of time. God knows when that'll be. So people can judge it and make amends, but this ain't going to be hyperblob. This is going to be nice, smooth Alexandrian borders. If he didn't take it, or at least try to take it, then I don't think we'll be gunning for it. Besides, the goal is in the title. So if anybody is asking what's the goal in this run, then they're a bit stupid in the head. Protect our brethren in Naxos, that would give me a free claim, but... Oh, I can't build a proper fleet at this stage. Yeah, one other thing is the peace is bringing down the autonomy. Slowly, but it is doing that. Go for Theodoro. Crimea, Alexander was there for sure. Yeah. Okay, the money is... I was about to say hurting, but that minus is misleading. We will not be culture converting to Greek. We might be doing culture converting Greek, but nah. After all, we are Lombard. And if I'm not going hyper blob, I might actually like to do quite a bit of culture converting. Oh, I don't need you around, and you're costing me money that would be better spent on just about anything else. But making absolutely sure that we keep these alliances is kind of important. So... not sure if it's worth keeping you or not. I really don't want these guys just to bust the alliance like that. Jake, support Urbino rebels in Pope land, then declare when they revolt. Yeah, his list of alliances are pretty beefy. Let's get these claims on the go and figure out where to go from there. And those Moraines really wanting to rise up. Our military power is somewhat lacking. On the plus side, With a force limit of 4, we can't really get too much of a revolt. Could still get a pretty nasty revolt. Where are my ships? Okay. Probably would not hurt having a few cogs, since that will help us get our ships, our troops over. I also really want to increase stability, however I also need to core my lands. I'll just have to rely on 75% of that is, yeah, what am I building? Probably not worth my time though, it's only 5 prestige. Alright, so hypothetical world where I declare war on, yeah, I wouldn't mind my country breaking to rebels to restore my stability, but when they would be Mauryan nationalists, absolutely not. Jake, will you conquer India to fulfill Alexander's dream? Nah. Trying to conquer India killed Alexander, so let's not try that. I feel like my diplomats are wasting away here, though. And not having the stability doesn't tell me what the hypothetical outcome would be if I were to boot the boot in. Harumph. More harumph. Okay, so one of my allies is getting hard to work destroying Hungary. Unfortunately, that's not going to be an expansion location for us. It's tempting to start putting claims on the Ottomans, since they're going to be coming for us, and it would be kind of nice to join up my lands. I'm going to start with Tirhala. Having Greek as an accepted culture means that these lands will be quite nice in our possession. Mothball the navy, Jake. Ah, good point. I'd almost forgotten about that. Gotta save those fractional ducats. Not liking the way... Okay, we still have the truce, so there's no way he's going to gun us down, but he probably will consolidate his power around here. Also, I must have blinked because Serbia got destroyed. Wait, just joined the stream. Did he start as Greece and get freedom from Byzantium? I'm not Greece, I'm Athens. Also, Ottomans are probably not too impressed at how we are fabricating claims on them. And they took the City of World's Desire, so... Yeah, they really want Constantinople. Wouldn't mind putting my capital there pretty swiftly. But let's get those cores on the go first and foremost. And I'm not keeping my eye on those Mauryan nationalists. They will probably pop up before I can even notice. It's kind of telling me to stick my troops on Constantinople, but I don't know how big a revolt would be if one popped up there. I do somewhat wonder. It should be limited to 4, because that's my force limit. The idea is no individual revolt can be higher than your force limit, unless you have spectacularly large overextension. Wait, it's 80% here and 90 there. What do I believe? Well, I believe I would rather not get a revolt right now. Oh, incoming Ottoman truce break. Yeah, close enough, they went for Karaman. But, yeah, that's a lot of base tax. It's about to become full Ottoman. And I can't really galley block them at this stage. I mean, we are considerably weaker than Blurple starts off as. Our only real advantage is that we have all these meaty allies on our side, kinda hoping that they carve a path through Hungary into me. A lot depends on what kind of access you can get. I think Hungary is fairly happy to give you access, yeah. Of course, the other part would be if you could... if I could stand up to Ottomans even with you on my side, because the Ottomans, sure enough, are going to have military tech 4 soon. And they get it faster than most others. Ho ho, now we're talking. 100 military power is lovely, but I can't say no to stability. Not at this stage. So, this hypothetical war. Austria will not join in because it's a distant war. However, Venice would then get involved, and I am fairly certain Austria would then go, "Oh, Venice is my enemy. I'm going to join in on your side now." But the other side, oh, Burgundy would get involved as well, and you hate Burgundy. Now, if I were to fight you dead on, you would love a piece of that action. But the buts just don't stop. Venice dominate the navy. So, if I were to ship troops over to Naxos and somehow win this battle, then I would be stuck there. And if Venice suddenly decided that they want Constantinople or all this jazz, I would be out of luck. Although Austria would come in and ravish them. You know what, that's something to think about when I'm more awake. I know this has been one of my shortest streaming sessions ever, but I was working hella late today, and it's pretty late now. So this will be the start of what will probably, hopefully be, a fairly short campaign, because we'll be having common sense soon. Potentially sooner than you think, so pack your party bags for that. Till then, though, it's like 11:45, I'm going to sleep. Blurple is gone, we're turning everything grey, my favourite colour, so. Oh, yeah, let me make a vague promise that this stream will continue tomorrow at about 7:30. Central European summertime. Yeah. Heard it here first, folks. Alright, good night. Ciao for now, and only settle for greyskin, I suppose.